Welcome back, everybody, here to what is our LAN finals. It is the lower bracket final. We must eliminate one team over the course of the next, however, hour or so. It is this game, Fnatic EU going up against Team Empire. Fnatic EU having a pretty damn strong first game, but Team Empire coming back in the second, almost undone by Divine Rapier, but Divine Intervention was not going to be there, and it is now locked up at one apiece. Let's jump ourselves straight into the draft, and luckily, I've got a guy who's going to be joining me in through Skype, so now he can unmute himself and say hello. Hopefully all the levels go right. What is up, Clairvoyance? Wait, whoa. Okay, that's interesting. That's interesting. Might have wanted to test this before. I'm hearing you now, but give me a second. I gotta change your inputs around, as I'm pretty sure you're coming through the wrong thing. So let me hit that button, and now try talking.
Hello, hello, 1, 2, 3, check,
beautiful, check. Fantastic, awesome. So welcome, man, welcome.
Splendid, splendid. It's good to be here. Game 3, here we go.
Yeah, man. Looking forward to it. What did you think of game number 2?
I saw the end of it. Just about the last 10 minutes. And I had to kind of just rely on the stream chat for the rest of it. And it looks like they said Storm has to be reported. So I'm not sure what's going on there. But I'm just going to have to say that Storm must have underperformed to an extent.
There was some definite issues with the Storm Spirit. When you're 20 minutes in, you're walking around with boots, and that's basically boots and bottle, and that's the summary of your items. Something is wrong. Something is seriously wrong. The supports on Empire side had more net worth than the Storm did, so I can understand that one.
That's not no bueno. Wow. Interesting.
Yeah, it was an amazing man. But let's check out this game right now with the draft, because I'm already seeing Puck being banned out here. I know some guy in the chat instantly said, why ban Puck? Team Empire is the first pickup. But they go with the Keeper of the Light instead. And again, Wisp, every single game this tournament, he has not let through that first set of bans.
That's interesting, too, because just in the matches just before the LAN, I haven't been seeing Keeper too much as a first pick, especially after the small nerf that he got. I mean, needless to say, he still does perform the similar functions that he did before. But yeah, I guess the reduction to the AoE kind of made some teams hesitant to pick it up. But then again, this is Empire. They have their own style, distinct style. I mean, last game they picked Sven and won with it. So yeah, looks like they're either bringing back the old or they're sticking to their guns and making things work.
Yeah. Well, yeah, it did kind of feel like you're saying sticking to their old going with the classic kind of thing. And it did feel like that. It felt like Empire from about a month ago. They've been trying new and different things, trying to find that that winning lineup, which for them is just perfect. And yeah, that's maybe the old one is the best one to go back to. It seemed to work. But now they're up against Fnatic, we're going to see Rubick for the first time in a while now appearing on the stage. So Nature's Prophet as well as Rubick. This is kind of almost classic Fnatic with their ability to split push. Keeper of the Light, the first one. I'm wondering if Team Empire just says, screw it, let's just go for the PL. They've been ignoring it. In fact, they pass up the opportunity multiple times over the course of... Okay, screw that. Okay, they're not going to do it. But they have passed it up multiple times. They're going to pass it up again. Queen of Pain and a Gyro pickup now for Team Empire.
Yeah, and it's actually funny too. I was watching the G1 League yesterday, along with some of the StarLadder games, I was talking to some pros. I was wondering why PL is not just being picked up. Because, you know, with the recent surge, with, you know, PL being counterpicked before the enemy team takes the PL as well as the Caudill or other things like just grabbing PL early and then just having him farm up.
Yeah.
I came to the conclusion that, yeah, the hero is actually still extremely, extremely powerful. The problem with PL is when you pick that hero, your team is actually forced into a specific playstyle that'll never change. And at the end of the day, no matter what you think, when you have a PL on your team, you're going to be looking to split push. You're going to be looking to avoid fights, and you're going to be looking to protect your tri-lane regardless of what happens. And so when you're forced into that kind of a playstyle, I mean, sometimes you sack the PL and just try to get levels of it. But yeah, it just kind of makes your movements a little bit predictable. And I guess some teams have kind of just figured out how to counter it, or other teams may just, they just don't want to deal with it. Like, for example, heroes like Undying, which are still really powerful, they haven't received too much nerfs, but they kind of just fell off because people don't enjoy the playstyle. And I think that's kind of just what's happening with PL. But I do expect PL to be seen in the ban stages just for safety measures.
Yeah, yeah. I wouldn't be surprised if that is the case. But I think you're right about it in one way. But I also think it comes down to a different thing where, like, you go for a PL in the late game and you kind of know you're going to be a little bit weaker in the early portion of the game. And when you come to a tournament like this, being weaker in the early portion of the tournament is the worst thing that could possibly happen to you. When you got teams like Empire that pick up Tree and Protector and try and blow your base down in like 20 minutes time, the PL never hits a mark where he can really do something for his team. It kind of feels like the old days of, like, we know Andy Mage is a good hero, we know he could farm up a lot more, but we also know that he requires space. He needs space to do what he would normally do, and that's just farm and then kill everybody by standing in one spot. Like, that's what we used to see from him. That just doesn't work in this kind of setup right now. So we go with our last set of bans. Team Empire, they don't ban out the PL. They take out Nakes, Weaver, and Darkseer. Again, every single time that Weaver is finding his way in the ban pool, I think I would love a percentage for this one, but I'm pretty sure at least in 3/4 of the games we've seen him being banned out. Be it against Blow Your Brain, in this case also possibly banning off against Fnatic's offlaner, and then Mag going to be the last ban out from Fnatic. Lone Druid again not finding his opening, and the Bane being the third pickup, the third ban too. It did really cause some issues from Silent when he was running around with that guy before, but we go into our last stage of picks now.
Yeah, and just one interesting note from last game that looks like it's kind of carrying over. Yeah, so there is the Templar from Empire, but more importantly, the Earthshaker pickup. Now, last game, from what I understand, Honey played it. Could you confirm?
Yes, actually he did, but okay. There's been some changes with what's happening with Hani, because like he was playing mid solo, and then there was a moment with Puck yesterday, and I'm wondering if he's been pushed into a different role just because of that, or if it's just because Hani loves playing as Earthshaker. Remaining.
Yeah, I don't know. It was just interesting to me how last game, like, No-Tail played Puck instead of Hani, and Hani was on the Earthshaker, and yeah, every time the ES is picked, I have seen him go to the long lane with Earthshaker. You know, he just picks up the boots, starts walking around the map trying to find kills.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I'm not sure if they're going to do that again this game, but it's certainly a possibility, which would lead me to question, what do they have in mind to put against the Templar Assassin? Because they cannot afford to, speaking of losing early games, they cannot afford to have a hero lose so badly to the Templar Assassin in the lane that that just has no game impact in the mid game. Remaining.
I also want to say privet to all the Russians who just tuned into our live stream, and StarLadder's main stream just went down. I can tell you it's not a network issue because we're both on the same live stream, both on the same network line. But it does now mean we could finally patch ourselves back over to the main boys up on the stage.
Wow. Oh man, Toby.
What a best crossover for Fnatic.
We're watching Dota from 2 months ago right now.
It does feel like it. And the really hilarious thing is, his signature hero is galore too, because you look at the Templar Assassin pickup, and this actually leads me to say this is an aggressive tri-lane by Empire, because Scandal, we all know how great a player he is as Templar Assassin, but the Queen of Pain is taken by Vigos to the middle lane, which is going to push, and we get the OD. Now, I'd be very skeptical with this hero, and if Fnatic try and run this hero as a mid lane solo, it's going to go so horribly for them, it's not funny. Because, like, normally you think, okay, OD, Astral Imprisonment, you get rid of the Templar Assassin's mana, so it's the point where you can't even pop Refraction. But I'm actually even feeling this is a safe lane TA. I'm feeling this is a safe lane TA and then aggressive up on the top. Or TA goes up as a safe lane Gyro. Either way, that TA is going to be babysat, and Queen of Pain is going to be the man going up against Outworld Destroyer in the mid. Just feeling it right now, man. And No-Tail, I don't even know how much success he's going to have on that bottom lane.
No, he definitely won't have very much successes in the bottom lane. He'll probably just opt for the jungle. Actually, looking at his items now, he decided to get some branches. He's actually going to try to go to the lane, which I don't agree with. But once again, I mean, who am I to question his abilities? But with regards to the laning phase, though, Scandal did get pulled. He got pulled 2 pieces of regen. And I'm actually not sure when he's not a guy who goes to the mid lane and gets pulled usually. So I'm thinking this might be a safe lane Templar, as you said. And just the aggressive tri-lane, of course, coming out from Empire. Once again, standard Empire tri-lane. This is Empire from literally 3 months ago, where they did this every single game. Pick their keeper, pick their undying, and then pick a very strong tri-lane hard carry like Gyrocopter, and then just go try to smash the other guy safe lane. And Fnatic, same thing. They're running something from a couple months back. Sven falling out of favor for a long time. Just making it surge back, I guess, within the last two games. Here, this game, as well as last game. And we'll see if it has successes.
Chasing those extra experience points early on. But now Fnatic know what they're up against. So let's run through our lanes very, very quickly. So Hani will be up here on the top lane as the Earthshaker. Fly supporting him as the Rubick. Era will be the remainder of that aggressive tri-lane. The aggressive tri-lane going up against them. It will be Silent on the Keeper of the Light. It is Captain Arthur, which is Goblack. He is there as the Undying. The Resistance, which is Blow Your Brain, as the Gyrocopter. In towards the mid lane. It does actually look, and I'm surprised at this one, they're going to run Scandal in the middle lane again. It's not the role he normally takes ever since Vigos did join up in Team Empire when Fnatic left them. Scandal switched himself to the offlaner. And funny enough too, because I thought that OD was going to be up against him, no tell in fact will now take the solo middle nature's profit, which puts OD as a solo bot up against Queen of Pain. So Empire will still be very, very happy with these lanes. I'm wondering if this change up with the TA and the solo mid is just because I thought Fnatic was going to do something different as well.
Wow, and you know what? I got to give credit to Fnatic for picking this up at the last second. Not only are they dealing with two full solos, but they've actually optimized the lanes and did their warding so well that like these lanes are actually going to work out. The only thing really in question is their tri-lane, because Prophet at mid is able to use Treants to burn off refraction charges. But more importantly, OD against Queen of Pain, especially an OD with Illusion Rune, that's not going to spell well for Queen of Pain either. So congratulations to them in their laning phase. They're going to do a lot better than their previous setup with the OD in mid as well as the Prophet in the long lane. Mm-hmm. But their tri-lane, this Sven is actually not going to get any farm against the Undying and the Keeper. They don't have anything. They have defensive supports that can stop an aggression, that can maybe potentially stop a tower dive before Undying has Tombstone. But even when Undying has Tombstone, I'm just not sure what Fnatic can pull up in order to keep their carry safe. And we see Goblack playing extremely aggressive here.
Yeah, well he wants to and he needs to. He needs to stay as close to that front line as possible. Always make Fnatic think that someone's going to be jumping this one out. And here they go. They're going to move over and try and contest the ball. They've got a good ward on the lane, but as you said before too, so did Fnatic. They can see this coming in. The Coddle Blast will fly through, take a little bit of the creep wave out, and now maybe even with the Rocket Barrage to finish this off. He's going to go with Flat Cannon instead. Forces fly back a little bit, but at the same time, Era will just wait for the new creep wave to come up. Or maybe not. No, it's not. Sant intercepted and pulled it over the troll camp. They are really trying to control this up completely. And Blow Your Brain, actually a little bit of trouble. The Fidget's there. It holds him in position. But no one wants to come close enough to go against that. The Tombstone was already been used, and with the Decay, taking away a little bit too many of the life points, no one wanted to go in on that one.
Yeah, and that's interesting, because as soon as that Fissure block hit, and that was a really, really, that was absolutely perfect for a Fissure block, but not only did somebody not die.
Oh, by the way, Clairvoyance, turn your mic on inside of Dota TV.
Inside of Dota TV, huh?
Yep, because people inside Dota TV aren't here. Sorry to the guys in Dota TV, I'm not using my normal system, so we're just patching him in through Skype here and then using the Dota TV, which I don't normally do. I normally route through my mixing desk back in Berlin. So yeah, apologies for that one. And let's see how you go now, man.
Yeah, I'm not getting pampered today, guys. Sorry about that. But yeah, once again, just nobody died in that engagement, but Empire did something really smart. I was wondering why Goblack wasted the Tombstone there. It has 60 seconds on the cooldown, and when it's down, they're really, really vulnerable to kills. But I realized SS actually pulled the big camp and denied the entire wave of EXP. So Empire is just playing this flawlessly in the tri-lane right now. They are playing this to perfection. Blow sitting at the highest CS in the game. Second is No-Tail at the mid lane, but that's okay. Templar will farm on the Furion no matter what. And yeah, they're in a really, really good position right now. And the only thing I really fear for is the safe lane, which has the Queen of Pain against the OD. OD is kind of crushing the Queen, as you can see. 12-13 in CS, Queen has 7-0. I don't think Viggles can do much in this lane.
Nah, he's getting absolutely nothing. It's not just the fact he's not getting like the last hits, it's the fact he's getting denied out. So the level experience, we're 4.5 levels in comparison to just under 4 levels. So 3 and just over 3 quarters. This is nowhere near what they want to be. And because like Trixie's finding all the mana in the world, I love his build too. Like, he's not building to do damage, he's building to control. He goes with the 2 points up in the Essence Aura, and now he might even actually have the damage.
Dead.
He's going to bring down Vigos. Vigos can't fling himself away. One more hit, and he gets it too. Diving on the bottom lane, able to take it in past the tower, and he just put up his Strangle Boots. Just wasted his Strangle Boots, but still, he has his Strangle Boots up and running and takes the first blood in the bottom lane.
Well, I got to say, you know, just watching that whole thing happen, I mean, I was ready to scream out, oh, he big first blood, but, you know, it was kind of just anticlimactic. Him just walking next to him, just A-walking him. And yeah, once again, this lane, like, anytime you have a matchup where OD is going up against an Inc hero, every time he steals a little bit of mana, you have to realize that he actually steals a huge chunk of damage. And when you have this damage difference, the OD will just win every single man fight engagement, and especially heroes like Queen of Pain who rely on good harassment to maintain lane control, it's just not there. And you know, once again, I fear for the game impact coming out of Queen of Pain in the mid game because he's having such a bad start.
Well, basically there is no impact. But at the same time, Sven, Ira's actually found some good CS up here. He's managed to find a lot more than I thought he was going to, and I wasn't expecting him to be inside double digits. He's 18 for 1, up against a 26 for 2. Sure, Gyro's got a small advantage up on here, but in comparison to all the other lanes, for how much they probably could have lost this try line up on the top, Fnatic hold a little bit more of this advantage, and then the Coddle Blast, and then of course the Barrage, and everything else they throw out stops the creep wave from coming in. They farm it up quickly. And the advantage is only to Fnatic by about 200, 250 on both experience and gold. But it still just shows you, for up against an aggressive tri lane, and heroes like TA and Quap.
Oh, mid lane, Toby?
Mid lane, they just profit. No tell. Try TP out, not time. Scandal on it. So they get a revenge. They get a revenge kill here in the middle lane.
Yeah, once again, very nice kill. I don't personally think that's actually supposed to happen. I guess when a Templar is bottle crowing, it makes things difficult for the Prophet, but once again, it's just kind of like when you switch up lane distributions so much in big tournaments without having the most efficient practice on them. Like, you know, for example, a guy who plays Prophet 1,000 games will always play a better Prophet than a guy who is really good at Dota but still plays Prophet like 10 games. The experience factor is really huge, and I just feel like I don't know. It's not the always most optimal thing, but Notail is going for the rune, and so far everything looks pretty stale except for the bottom lane, which seems very, very aggressive going on for Fnatic.
Man, I need you to scream at me for a moment in case something's about to happen, because I think there's something wrong with the overlay. And in fact, now it's happening on top lane. Already Blade Ray picked up. Problem trying to help him out, and he will go down here. Coddle Blast, there's a little bit of extra damage, but the kills are still up here, and they're going to go for a second one. Got like a little bit too far up, and now be Notail. Quick Soul Rip, trying to keep him alive. Notail needs another extra hit in here, and he gets it too. So double kill for the TPing in Notail. Takes the blood on the top.
Yep, very nice. And Fnatic's gonna pick up a tower on this, so this is very good. As for how Blow Your Brain is gonna react is the most interesting thing. But it looks like the push is actually dying, and heroes are just gonna back because they're low. And yeah, here it is, Blow. He's just coming back to hold the lane with Goldback. I mean, Silent.
Oh, that's what you guys are talking about. Yeah. It's not hiding any information, guys, on the overlay. Everything is still fine. It's just there's a little bit of a glitch on how far the overlay goes down next to my name and clairvoyance. That's the only reason why.
That sounds splendid.
It's not the best, but yeah. Nothing's being hidden from the game, so that's what counts.
Interesting. And rotation up to the top lane by Scandal. Wonder if Era's gonna die out of this one.
Yeah, diving on Era.
Wonder no more. He's dead.
Scandal just straight in. Meld hit 2, already down in negative armor. Uses the Warcry, bounce off. Nice Storm Bolt though from Era. And then the Fissure Fallout from Hani. Gives a lot of extra space here. And that's a rotation of 4 of their heroes to try and get that one kill. And then a 2-man Storm Bolt. Plus the follow-up. Fissure, it was more than enough to escape.
Well, Toby, they say keep your words tender and soft attack, because you never know when you're going to eat them. And it looks like I just have to eat my words, because 4v2 and Era getting out of that gank with a nice Storm Bolt followed up by a very nice stun from Hani. And looks like some aggression in the bottom lane with massive things coming out.
Yeah, OT's looking for a kill, but a very quick TP out. But they have to abandon bottom lane. Tier 1 tower is gone. They can't hold it. And this OD, you see what he's building into? Early point booster.
I haven't really seen the Agonist build come out very often. I'm gonna actually just go and throw it out that might be a casual point boost.
I wouldn't be surprised if it's a casual point boost, and then going into something like a 4-star or...
Yeah, definitely. I just don't know about the efficiency of rushing an Aghanim Scepter against the line of Vampire right now. I mean, you already have enough burst damage. The Aghanim's bonus does not really kick in until you have a large amount of int. Then the difference kind of just scales because it's a multiplier. But
trouble for Era. Top lane. He has to lift that war cry. Without it, he would have gone down just there. On the run back out again. And Team Empire. Well, they hold their ground. I also apologize, guys. There's a little bit of lag coming through on my computer. I have no idea why. I'll see if I can sort it out. Give me a minute.
What's going on?
Just a small issue. Just a small issue. Hopefully it doesn't last for too long.
Well, it looks like Fnatic has an issue on their hands. Mid lane.
Yeah. Middle lane, no tell, but he only just got out in time. Able to TP himself away to safety.
Very nice reaction by NoTail. Fnatic's coming in, rotating to defend the mid lane. Looks like Empire is going to be committing to it. They're bringing five heroes to the mid. This is going to give ERA a lot of room to farm. And I fear that they actually have to take more towers, be more aggressive with their tower taking, because they have all these early game heroes. But as you said, ERA did find good farm at the top lane, but most importantly, he didn't die. If a carry doesn't die within the first 10 minutes, it usually spells well for the carry, because regardless, they're always in a position to get experience. And yeah, we'll have to see how that pans out for Empire.
Well, 1-3 now. Sorry guys, I know it's still lagging up a little bit on my screen, but it's not as bad for the live stream. Flight, a lot of trouble right now. Sprout to go down, give him a little bit extra space. Scanner wants to go a little bit further. There's a lot of players here committing towards the middle lane, but they still cannot find the opening. They cannot find it. At the same time, OD3 are going to try and solo up bottom lane. Coming down, finds Blow Your Brain, and he's never alone. Nature's Prophet TP's in to help out. And Blow Your Brain running out in the bottom lane.
Yeah, that's a fast helicopter.
Ping's fine. Sorry, I'm still losing frame rate, guys. I'm still losing frame rate. I'm going to try and crash something and see if it helps it.
Interesting.
Yeah, sorry. Normally I hate this because it's not my setup, so I don't know where things go horribly wrong. Yeah.
Well, sad reality is you live with what you get. And looks like in terms of getting, Empire will get the tower at mid lane, but Fnatic's still looking very strong. They still have all of their cores farming without pressure. And yeah, looking at Trixie's inventory now, looks like he's going for the mech for the team fight. Era still just farming up safely on the top lane. Scandal rotating top along with a level 7 Queen of Pain. They're looking to get a kill. There's massive pings coming out, but Era being smart already, he's just TPing out. He doesn't even want to risk anything. And Hani sitting here without a TP scroll, getting trapped and stolen up by Scandal. Now, that is something that should not be happening at this point in the stage.
Yeah, not quite sure why he was still there. Really not quite sure why he was still there. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, Blow Your Brain's gonna go down. NoTail as well as Trixie able to get that kill. Teaming up together. And you see now the build from Trixie. It's a casual point boost, but it's not going to be the 4-star we were thinking of. He goes into a mech instead.
That's right. Teamfight oriented build. It'll definitely help him a lot, as well as the team.
I also apologize, too, if I say anything you were saying, because I was trying to fix the problem, unfortunately.
Oh,
I wasn't listening.
That's okay. It's no issues. But I just want to bring out one thing, that like this OD not getting pressured on the enemy's safe lane, so in the aggressive lane, it's gonna actually turn out to be a huge problem. The fact that the Furion can just keep TPing in to get single pickoffs on giant, like huge importance heroes like Blow Your Brain's Gyrocopter, this is not something that Empire can afford happening right now.
Alright, Trixie, real trouble for him on the bottom line. Nuked out before he can TP out to safety. Very, very easy initiation there for Team Empire.
That's right. And this is what should be happening every time Trixie does come to this lane. And to be fair, OD, you have to kind of just sit and farm in the lane that you started out with. So he will have to come, otherwise he'll be taking Era's farm in the safe lane or the mid lane, which will just always have a ping pong effect and push back and forth. Looks like engagement at the top lane though.
Yeah, it's gonna be now Keeper of the Light. No, quick TP out. Team Empire can't get there in time. Scandal even blinking himself in. Maybe they could chase down Era for a quick moment. But now he's backing out to safety.
That's really unfortunate. Scandal shift queued his blink from the tower TP. And he didn't make it to the ledge. If he made it to the ledge and saw Era, he would have definitely gone for the trap as well as the...